learning to love negativity. Learning to love negativity. Negativity is a beautiful thing. Now, why is it a beautiful thing? Because without negativity, positivity wouldn't exist. So, if negativity didn't exist in the world, where would we all be? Well, that's a good question. Who knows? But one thing for sure is when we start to look around us and we start to see negativity, it's a beautiful thing. Because being positive and being joyful and being loving and being generous and being charismatic and being, you know, friendly and you know, kind. You know, negativity, I can't stand these vibrations. Negativity just doesn't want to acknowledge any sense of state of elevation or even a state of presence, because within negativity, presence doesn't exist. Negativity doesn't exist in presence. It exists in a realm of hatred. So when we start to look at negativity, we start to love negativity, because we can understand that without negativity, we wouldn't have the chance to resemble our true self. We wouldn't understand, or we wouldn't have an anchor, we wouldn't have an adjacent force to our creation. We wouldn't see the eye of the storm without the energy circling it. So within the eye of the storm, we can be safe, and we can move with the eye of the storm, and we can understand that as long as we're moving with the storm, we can lay out in the sun and nothing will go wrong. But we have to be moving with the storm as we have to be loving, caring with these vibrations, because we don't want to get caught up in these vibrations and we don't want to be lost in these vibrations. But even if we get lost and caught up in these vibrations, there is no negativity that exists within our true self-love. So as long as we can learn to come back to our self-love, or learn to find our way back to our self-love, we can understand that no matter how negative the scenario, or no matter how negative the scenario, that we understand how to come back in to the heart of to the eye of the storm. Because even if we drift out, even if we lose ourselves sometimes, we will understand that we have the guidance to come back into that self-love. Now, for a lot of us, we're fighting to find that eye of the storm. We're fighting to find that inner truth, or that seeking that wisdom of love, joy, and happiness. And a lot of us will continue to fight until the day we die for this. Now, there is no negativity, so it doesn't matter if we have to go through this whole life. Because if we can find balance within understanding that we can search for harmony within a spectrum of continuum, there's no rush. There's no rush. There's no rush. There's no expectations for love to connect with us. There will only be distractions, and whether we get distracted in this lifetime, there's no negativity. So there's no point in attaching a negative thought to expectations, because then we become predictions. Love continuum and everything will fall into its place.